a wappy outside with. Honey be in the session, we be wildin'. Won't catch me playin' with my broke nigga, this child.
Busy. I've been up since 6 a.m. It's about to be 7 p.m. and I haven't took a nap. I didn't went to the gym. Y'all saw everything I did, but it's currently about to be 7. So I'm done with all my classes. As y'all saw, I went to class and I didn't went to the gym, went back home and showered and changed into this. Went to another class. Now I'm at this event with CAB because I'm on campus activity board. So yeah, I'm at this event, but having a movie premiere today. Yeah, that's just that. It's a movie premiere for a Snoop Dogg new movie, Rap Snacks is here. So it's gonna be a really nice event. I probably won't be able to get as much footage because I'm not gonna be able to attend the event. I'm actually working the event and I actually have a big important job because I'm on tech. So I'm the one who's gonna be playing the movie. Y'all, exactly. But let's go back inside. How it look for now, and they just still setting everything up. I'm gonna be over here because I gotta play the movie and do everything. So, yeah.
If y'all wanna know why,
I was like, she's
no, come put y'all on blast, okay? If y'all wanna know why I have tech, blame my two friends, right? Who gave me the hardest job.
Hey y'all.
You're gonna do great. Number one content creator, y'all. Number one.
This is not content. I'm like, okay, maybe I'm being here taking some behind the scenes.
She press and play. She plays a major role in tonight's event. Let's do an applause right here.
Yay. No. Like what?
And she look cute doing it. Who you know got a Miss Heritage that's on tech?
No. But it's just okay. I'm gonna go pray because if I don't hit it at the right time. And I want to say,
oh yeah, and I'm gonna just look.
They're gonna. I'm gonna say, I'm gonna say my name is Eric.
I'm just putting, no. I'm gonna just put the spotlight on you. Just the light just go too.
That's crazy. The song. No recording devices of any kind of our love. Please turn those songs on. We're ready for the screening.
Because again, I don't.
Hey.
Hurry.
Jayla checking in.
Yeah.
Ready for movie night tonight?
Yeah.
You there?
Yeah.
Going here.
Yeah. Do what you do.
Play Baby's vlog. It's K-Star. As you can see, I'm here.
Hey y'all, good morning. I don't even know if I really got a chance to talk to y'all yesterday. I had a very long, it wasn't long, it was just a busy day, like a packed day, but it was a good day. I actually got everything done on my schedule, so I'm very grateful for that. I love a day where I check off everything. I'm going to be filming a weekly vlog this week, so I'm going to just be bringing y'all along with me for the whole week. But y'all already knew that from the title and the thumbnail and everything like that. It's currently 8:28 a.m. Yeah, yesterday I had an 8 a.m. class, and then y'all saw what I did yesterday. So yeah, but today is Tuesday. My day is pretty much going to be the same way as yesterday. I have a 9 a.m. class that's over at 10:50. That's over at 10:40, and I have a class at 10:50 to like 12. But the good thing is they're literally in the same room, so I don't even have to leave. But the bad thing is I'm going to be in the same room from 9 a.m. to like 12. So it's like, and but y'all know that room that I had went to yesterday with all the computer lab, well, like all the computers, the same room that I went to like twice, that's where I'm going to be going at for my other classes. Literally all of my classes except for like one class is in that same building, because y'all know I'm a computer science major and I'm getting into a lot of my major courses right now, so they're all in that same building in that same room. So yeah, but I just woke up this morning, did my skincare. I just like went through my hair a little bit. I woke up and drank my detox pineapple drink with a shot of apple cider vinegar. Yesterday I had started to feel like I was getting a cold, which is why I had came back in the house and drank some tea. So this morning, like every morning, I've been trying to drink like a protein smoothie, but this morning I didn't drink a protein smoothie. I have me a cup of hot tea because I still feel it. So I'm probably not gonna drink a protein smoothie until after I leave the gym as my lunch or whatever, because that's probably why my voice sound like this. But yeah, I'm just drinking this tea. I probably eat a muffin, something light, something small, y'all. I am trying to, you know, I am in a gym, so I am trying to lose weight. So I'm trying to just watch what I eat as much as I can. But I'm not torturing myself, because at the end of the day, I still am, you know, in college. And, you know, there's a lot of different emotions that goes into just being in college. So sometimes if I wanted to go get some chicken or a cookie, I'm not going to deter myself from doing it. But I am, you know, I am eating better. I'm meal prepping. I'm, you know, doing the necessary steps to take, you know, to eat better. But I'm just not in a strict diet where I'm like forcing myself not to have something, because y'all, college is already stressful enough, and then on top of that, I'm already going to the gym inside of my busy schedule and making time for that. So if I do feel the need that, okay, I want some chocolate today, I had something upsetting me, I just want a little chocolate, I'm going to get some chocolate. But yeah, so it's currently actually, but it says raining, which is crazy. And it's literally raining, and my walk is like a 15-20 minute walk. That's the crazy part. Every morning I take a 20 minute walk, because my building where my computer science classes is all, it's basically at Morehouse campus. And I'm all way over here in Heritage, and this is basically at Chick-fil-A. So you do the math. If you know, you know. But yeah, I just wanted to quickly come in here and update y'all. Just tell y'all a little bit about what's been going on. And today after I leave my class, I'm gonna go to Mimi's pantry to get some, see if I can get like some meat, some groceries. I think I want to start going to Mimi's pantry. That's where they give you free groceries. I want to start going there to get some free groceries and then go to the market to get whatever else I don't buy, because they be having chicken and stuff like that. So if I can save some money, I'm gonna save some money, period. So after that, going to the gym. After I leave the gym, come home, shower, change how I did yesterday, and then I have another CAB event that's with Campus Activity Board. I think it's Taco Tuesday today, so I'm gonna be working that. But before I go, every morning I've been reading this book. It's like every day there's a different page. It's called The Golden Presents Daily Inspirational Readings. And so like I've just been like every day I read a page and I take notes. Well, that was a bad flip through, but. So yeah, today is January 23rd. Like I told y'all, so we're on the 23rd. And I'm actually gonna read it with y'all today. I feel like that'll be actually really, I dropped the pen. Oh, here we go. I feel like that'll actually be quite nice if I read it with y'all. So I'ma just show y'all. The title is We Don't Lose Anything. Okay, that's the title of today. So it say, don't think that you can do everything just by your own capacity alone. Maybe this is a word for somebody. And before I even finish reading, let me just say this, okay? Because I believe in everything happens for a reason. I believe in perfect time. I believe in all of that. And so I feel like, yeah, I'm reading this on January 23rd. And when y'all see it, it won't be January 23rd. And let's just say I post this video and you watching this a week after I post it, and it's way past January 23rd. God is sending you here on my video, and he's kept you watching this long so that you could hear this message. So
take into account what this page is about to say. Don't matter the date. This is a message I feel like somebody needs to hear. So I don't know who out there watching that needs to hear this. But yeah, so I'm gonna start over for y'all. So that way y'all can really, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. He said, don't think that you can do everything just by your own capacity. Know that there is a higher power, grace, to help you out. Okay. And so I like to underline as I go through like stuff that stick out to me. So yeah. But you have to sincerely ask for it. Okay, so you have to ask for it. Unless you ask, you won't receive. Hello? But you... Unless you ask, you won't receive. I'm sorry, I got mixed up. Just by asking, you are opening yourself to that power. Okay, that is... Okay, it's not that God is waiting for you to ask. God is not miserly. God is already giving. He's already giving. But we do not always receive. Okay, and it's like three little paragraphs. So I'm going to just break down what I got from the first paragraph. What I got from the first paragraph is closed mouths don't get fed. And although God is not going to not give it to you because you ask, but at the same time, he's already giving. He's already giving you so much. But if you want more, you have to show him that you want more. You have to ask for more. You have to do more to receive more. So I'm going to just put a little arrow and I'm going to put closed mouths don't get fed. And when y'all like listening to us or whatever, if y'all like feel like y'all got something different from that paragraph, comment down below what y'all got from that paragraph. Like, I really want to know. This is something that I've been doing and it's really been helping me. Like, I try to take into account like every page. I read one page a day because they're literally dated every day of the year. So what I try to do is just take into account like, okay, I'm going to apply what I read for this page in my life today. You know what I'm saying? So, if y'all need if the book was online, it was cheap, I gave y'all the title, it's on Amazon, I'll add it to my storefront. I just recommend getting it. But let's get back to the word, okay? The process of asking is okay, let me calm down. the process of asking is itself opening. You cannot even ask without opening. You cannot even ask without opening. So open your heart. See, y'all might think he was talking about opening your mouth and asking, but it's so much deeper than that. Open your heart. Even if you can't open your heart to people, open your heart to God. Then you will know how to open your heart to people. Okay. Pray sincerely and trust in a higher power. Trust in a higher power. Trust in God. Many more things are wrought by prayer than the world dreams of. Okay. Let us believe in a sincere power. And that's the second little paragraph. And from that process, I just literally got open your heart. A lot of people think, I like to tie them all in together, y'all. I'm feeling something. I feel like what this is saying is basically like, okay, you don't get nothing if you don't ask, but you have to ask genuinely and sincerely and believe in it. And you can't act like, one thing I've been learning is you can't pray about something and then worry about something. You know what I'm saying? If you pray about it, you give it to God. So all your worries, all your anxiety about the situation goes away because you know that you gave it to God and whatever happens is in God's plan. So you can't worry about something. So I feel like if you're asking for more and you're praying for more, you have to sincerely open your heart and believe in that more is possible to come. You have to believe in the higher power. You can't just ask for it and then also still worry about it, still feel like you can't ask and pray to God, oh, I just want to make six figures, but don't believe in your heart that you are deserving of six figures. Am I talking to someone? Okay, let me get back. What we can achieve by ourselves is very little, but what we can achieve with the help of God is very great. We don't lose anything by giving ourselves to God. As the great Saint McAvoy, okay, I ain't even gonna lie to you, I don't know how to pronounce that word, said, I gave myself to God, I gave myself to you, God, in return you gave yourself to me, quotation marks. Who is gaining? With me, you are not gaining anything, just a useless thing incapable of doing even a little. I'll be a burden to you, one more stomach to feed, but with you I can do many things. If I have you, I have gained everything in the world. So you see, through you call it a fair business deal, you are really losing.
Wow. This was actually really great. I feel like what I got from this page today was just that. And I feel like this was perfect. This is right on time. You know what's crazy? Because every morning I wake up and I pray. And I literally prayed even before reading this page. And it was a prayer just, you know, just thanking God, but also telling him that I feel like I'm in a process right now. Like, I feel it physically, mentally, like everything. And I just thank God for that. And I feel like this page is telling me that stop worrying about if something's going to happen for me. Stop worrying about if I'm going to get something that I really want. Because I prayed about it and I gave it to God. And I had to genuinely open my heart and give it to the higher power and believe in the higher power and believe that it can get done because I gave it to God. So don't worry about it. Don't think about it if it's going to get done. Closed mouths don't get fed. You open your mouth now and open your heart. Mic drop. You open your mouth first and you ask God, but you also have to open your heart. Open your mouth, then open your heart and believe in the higher power and believe that all things you gave to God is going to get done and it's going to happen exactly how it's supposed to happen, okay? That's all I got to say. Get the book. I'm not sponsored. I'm really just trying to put y'all on though, because I know I'm talking for a little bit, but let me just say one other thing. I really feel like that book is really helping develop me, you know? And I just want to see everybody win. If we set on our goals, we set on our business this year, let's just hold each other accountable. And yeah, every day you need to be reading. Get the book. It's just one page a day. It's not that much. Really take the time. Like, I made it a part of my morning routine, but like, I really enjoy reading it. So yeah, but it is 8:40 and I have to go to class and it's actually raining, so I'm gonna try to leave out now. But yeah, all right, go to class, and then go to the gym, you know, same old, same old. So I'm gonna see y'all when I get to class. I'm not gonna record me walking or none of that because it's raining. That's what my phone says, raining, but it is raining. I can see a little bit of rain out my window. So yeah, I just got on this Nike swim breaker from yesterday because it's my gym hoodie, some leggings under my sweatpants because I got my gym clothes on. Because I don't want to have to come back to my room to change. So I just put on some sweatpants over top of my leggings. I'm going to put my gym shoes on. I'm going to put a coat on. Keep it pushing. Yeah. I'm going to see y'all at class. I am about to go drink some L-glutamine, some chlorophyll. And it's like this powdery pack. Supposed to be like IV fluids or whatever. Or something to help. So I'm going to drink that just so I can like try to fight off whatever cold I have coming. Because I felt it coming yesterday. But as of today, I don't feel it as much. I just have a little like stuffiness or like soreness in my throat. But as far as my chest, I'm feeling good. So I want to just keep it that way. So I'm going to take all the precaution steps. Y'all already know I'm going to have me my nice water. Yo, look, I got this little thing on my water. It's an L. Isn't that so cute? And then I don't know if y'all knew this, but at the top of my water cup, it says my name. A custom little thing. My mom made it. So cute. But if y'all ever see me with that, just know that I got lemon water in it. I haven't been drinking no soda, so proud of me, happy of me, standing on business. Yeah, but I love y'all. Let's go to class. Hey, vlog, we're in class.
You don't want to be in here.
Y'all, it's 47 people here. It's basically 50 students in this one class. But it's not 26, so. It's really 47 people, though? Like,
it's going to be a long ass
class. That's OD. Like, 47 people in a computer class. You know she not. You know she not helping.
She's not helping nobody. You're not getting your question answered at all.
It's fine. I'm about to get a tutor right now. We didn't even start.
Nope.
I wanna show you up. I wanna brag about it. I wanna tighten up. I wanna show you up.